For Buddhists, after we die, we will be reborn. And for the other religionists, they will go to hell or go to heaven. But what happened to those who do not belong to any religion?
Things never take place according to our belief. We can believe anything, but natural occurrences take place according to universal law or natural phenomena. Some people say they do not believe in rebirth. If rebirth is natural, can they stop their rebirth just because they don't believe it? Impossible. On the other hand, some people say, yes, we believe in rebirth. If there is no rebirth by nature, can they create rebirth just because they believe there will be a rebirth? That's why I told you, belief is not the important thing. Birth is natural. Sicknesses are natural. Old age is natural. Death is natural, not necessary to believe. If anything happens after our death, that is also natural. It does not happen according to our belief or according to religious practices or what you call concept. How can we prove that it is true? In fact, today, many people do not depend on religion or Buddhism. There are three, four religions like Buddhism, Hinduism, Jainism, Sikhism, who maintain this belief. Without depending on any religion, many people realized that it is true. When they hypnotize some people, they can recall their previous birth, explain everything, investigate it, 100% correct. Again, children in many countries suddenly remember their previous birth, start to tell everything about their previous birth. They have investigated all the information given by these children, correct. All of us have this memory, submerged, so we could bring up to our normal mind. According to modern psychology, we can say it is the subconscious mind. But one day, when we develop our mind up to the highest level of sainthood or arahanthood, or Buddhahood, then we can recall, we can remember all our previous birth. Again, let us use our common sense. Why there are so many discriminations amongst the human being? Who is responsible for that? Some people are dying, millions of them are dying without food and starving. Millions of them are living without shelter, without clothing, without medicine, and natural disaster, volcanic eruptions, and earthquake, and war. Why do they suffer? We have to end while we are enjoying our life. If there is anybody to create us, one group to enjoy their life, another group to suffer, then what is the reason? From the Buddhist point of view, we can say those who have done certain bad karmas, those who have not done good karmas, suffer. Quite reasonable. And those who have done enough good karma, those who have led respectable, noble life, can lead a peaceful, happy, contented life. That means life exists again and again. Differences take place according to our way of life, and nobody else is responsible for that. I think this is enough for us to understand that it is true.